in the truth that is Virat or Sutra, in that the whole creation is. So Otapurota means what? Just as a cotton completely pervades the cloth, and so also Virat or Sutra Atma completely pervades the creation. That's the idea there. Just as the hub pervades the spokes, and spokes pervade the wheel, because hub transmits its support and the motion through the spokes, etc. And so also the Lord transmits His existence and dynamism through, you know, through all these different names and forms, and therefore He alone, the whole creation is fixed unto Him, just as the spokes are fixed unto the hub. That's what is explained here in the Tika. Yatha rasasya nabhu araha samarpitaha. Just as in a nabhi or the hub of a ratha or a chariot, araha or the spokes are fixed. Teshu nemihi arpitaha. And upon the spokes we have the rim, the nemi. Tatha adhyatma adhibhuta adhideva bhinnam ashesha vijagat. And so also the whole creation consisting of adhyatma, adhibhuta and adhideva, the whole creation. Dirgatantuvarti. No, what? Dirgatantuvat, Tiryaktantuvat, Virat Sutra Avyakratatmasu Sthitam. So Virat Sutra and Avyakrata. So Adhibhuta, Adhideva, Adhyatma, Adhyatma, Adhibhuta and Adhideva. All this creation really is. So Adhyatma creation is supported by Virat, Adhibhuta by Hiranyagarbha, Adhideva by Ishvara or Avyakta, that way you can say. So this whole creation really is fixed into this Virat or Hiranyagarbha or Prajapati. So Dirgha Tantuvat and Tiryak Tantuvat, like the horizontal and the vertical, like the warp and the woof. So how the threads go and how therefore the whole cloth is woven, you know, into this thread, and so the whole creation is woven, or how the thread pervades the cloth through warp and woof, and so also this Hiranyagarbha Virat pervades the entire creation through the warp and woof that he is, and or how the Nabhi conveys its motion, etc. to the rim, and so also the existence and the dynamism that the creation has comes from Hiranyagarbha, or comes from Ishvara, from Atma. Vivida sevasa srishtihi iti hetu samiranam karanam nivihaye hai kari manyatra vartate. Vivida asya eva sa srishtihi. Then this whole creation is vividha, is asya, of the Prajapati alone, this is whole variegated creation. Iti hetu samiranam, that is really a statement of hetu, that this is a hetu. That it is, the whole creation is nothing but the manifestation of projection of one Prajapati. Therefore we say that Prajapati is all the devatas. So to say that esha eva sarve devaha, this Prajapati indeed is all the devatas. Why? Etasya eva sa visrishtihi, because this whole creation is the creation of one Prajapati. Therefore karanam na vihaya hiya kari manyatra vartate. Naturally kari or the product can never transgress the cause or the karanam. So says bhautikam hi sarvam bhutav vyatirekena nasti. Nicely it is said, how the elemental creation cannot be apart from the five elements. Bhautikam means elemental, that is made of the five elements. The whole creation made up of five elements does not stand apart from the five elements. Tani api panchikritani apanchikrita atirekena na santi. And also these five grossified elements do not stand apart from the ungrossified, the subtle five elements, apanchikrita. Tani api na vyakrita atirekena vidyante. And these five subtle elements also do not stand apart from the avyakrita, the undifferentiated, unmanifest, which is the cause. Tadabina pratyarekenasti, even that undifferentiated, unmanifest, which is what we call prakriti or the maya or the cause, also does not stand apart from Atma. The idea is that at no time can the effect ever stand apart from the cause. So how the elemental creation is non-separate from elements, how the gross elements are non-separate from the subtle elements, how subtle elements are non-separate from its cause, namely unmanifest, and how unmanifest is non-separate from the Purusha or the person or the Atma, who is the Adhisthanam. And therefore, the whole creation can never stand apart from Atma, who is the Adhisthanam. So, Karanam Navihayeha Karyamanyatra Vartate. So, Atma is a Karanam, the whole creation is Karyam, therefore, the whole creation can never be apart from Atma. Atah na kvachit bheda siddhi tyartha. Therefore, you cannot ever prove the bheda or the duality. Then the Tika continues there. Shruti yuktibhyam devata bhedam nirasya. By the Shruti, meaning that araya varasana abhav, and yukti karanam na vihayeha karyamanyatra vartate, that is the yukti. So by the Shruti and the Yukti, Devata Bhedam Nirasya, thus negating the Bheda or the duality among the Devatas, Etasyevasa Visushtiti Rasyarthamaha. Then Vartikara explains the meaning of the statement of the Shruti, Etasyevasa Visushtiti. This is the creation of this Prajapati, that is being explained. Vividha. So yatah evam atah devaapi sarve syuh prajapatihi. Yatah evam, since this is so, atah deva sarve api syuh prajapatihi. All the devas are nothing but prajapati. No, sorry. Vivida asyeva sa srishtihi iti hetu samiranam. Okay, that this is the cause, this is the hetu. That prajapati alone is all the devatas. Ya srishtihi agnyadya nana prastuta sa prakrutasya srishtuhoyavati yojana. This srishti of the Agni and the Soma and the Indra and all the devatas which is here presented is nothing but the creation of projection of one Prajapati alone. This is the idea. Esho hyevati uttarvakhyarthe hetu anena uchyate tatparyama iti hetu samiranam. That this is the projection of Prajapati is the reason why it is said that the Prajapati alone is all the devatas. Srashtuhu sarva devata hetu tumatra drishtam. Okay. Then the Srashta or the Creator is the Hetu or the cause of all the Devatas. Katham etat tasya sarva devatatmakatve karanam idi. You can say that Prajapati created all the Devatas. But how do we say Prajapati is all the Devatas? To say that Prajapati created all the Devatas, Agni etc. But to say that Prajapati alone is all the Devatas, how do you say that? Meaning he is Nimitta Karanam, alright. Why do you say that he is Upadana Karanam? And so it was said that karanam na vihaya iha karyam anyatra vartate, that a karya or the effect can never transgress the cause, prajapati being the upadana karanam, srishti being the karyam, therefore srishti can never be separate from prajapati. Hetu vakyartham uktva pratignyam adatte. Then this hetu is said, then pratignya meaning what? Esha eva sarve devaha. That Prajapati indeed is all the devatas. That is the pratignya. Why? Etasyeva sa visrushtihi. So pratignya is what? Esha eva sarve devaha. This Prajapati indeed is all the devatas. Why? Etasyeva sa visrushtihi. Because this is indeed his creation. So what? Because the effect can never stand apart from the cause. That is how? That's the vyapti. So pratignya, then hetu, and the vyapti, all of this is given here. That's how the Shruti statement is looked upon. Yatah evam atah devaha sarvevi sif prajapati vartika says. Sarvasya jagatah devadirupasya prajapati karyatvat karanadanyatrasya tadayogat tanmatram sarvam jagat ityartha. Sarvasya jagatah devadirupasya, this jagat consisting of devatas etc. Prajapati karyatva, since it is the karya or the effect of prajapati, karanat anyatra chita devagad, and karyam can never stand apart from karanam, tan matram saram jagat, meaning the whole creation nothing but prajapati. Understand why prajapati means atma, that's all you should understand. Prajapati means ultimately you should understand Brahma alone, Ishvara. pratignyam vibhajate. The pratignya is explained. Tasyam tasyam adhikrutu tattat rupam prapanyate. How Prajapati, depending upon a particular context, adhikara, Prajapati gets manifest as the particular devatas. So as the need be, as the situation may demand, Prajapati manifests as Agni or Adhikara for Brahmanas, manifests as Indra for Kshatriyas, manifests as Vasu, you know, for the Vaishyas, manifests as Pushan for the Shudras and so forth and so on. So tasyam tasyam adhikrutau tattad rupam prapadyate. For the different Adhikaris, this Prajapati alone attains or manifests as this different devatas. Then Tika says, ekasya nana rupatvam viruddham. How can one Prajapati become many? How can one appear as, how can one become many? Ekahiti. So says Bhartika, eka eva tu vishvatma mayaya mohayan jagata ekatam bahutameti kumbhavan mani samshaya. Eka eva tu vishvatma, vishvatma who is one alone, maya mohayan jagat. And so he deluding the whole creation by his maya, one lord alone deluding the whole creation by maya, ekatam bahutameti, he alone becomes one, he who is one alone becomes many. Ekatam bahutameti, he becomes one and he becomes many. Kumbhavat mani samshayat, if there is a prism kumbha, how kumbha or a pot appears to have different colors when it is in the vicinity of a prism? I guess that's what the idea is here. So as a prism reflects or refracts different lights, how one pot can appear to be of different colors depending on mani, or if mani radiates different lights. If mani is there, mani has red light, let us say, then if you place a kumbha in front of that, the kumbha will appear of a different color. How the same cloth appears different in different lights? That's why when you go to a shop, you think that the sari is so beautiful. When you come out, you know, in the sunlight, it looks different. That's a very common experience, you know. People spend a lot of money after, first of all, they spend 2.5 hours choosing the color, you know. And having chosen that, and of course that kapadiya knows exactly how to deal with this matter. And therefore, the cloth is all the right color, but very beautiful. When you come out, when you bring home, it's how beautiful it is. Then somebody says, what have you brought here, you know. This is not what you are talking about anyway. But how one kumbha or a pot appears to be a different color is because of upadhi of mani. And so also one lord appears to be many because of the upadhi. Abhinna eva bhutatma pratibhuta samaptitah ekada bahudha chaiva drishyate jalachandravat. Abhinna eva bhutatma, only atma who is one, non-dual, pratibhuta samaptitah, he gets totally manifest in every bhuta. One atma becomes totally manifest as Indra, as Varuna, as Yama, as Agni. Say, just as Gotva completely manifests itself in a cow, how the cowness manifests completely in a cow, so also Prajapati manifests in its totality in every living being. That's why everything is Brahma. See, Prajapati who is Brahma were divided into portions, and everybody has only a little portion of that Brahma, then you cannot say you are Brahma. That Prajapati totally is there in everyone, and therefore everyone is Brahma in totality. Therefore alone the Upadesha can be given that everyone is Brahma. Abhinna eva bhutatma pratibhuta samaptitah ekadha bahudha chaiva drishyate jalachandravat. Just as Chandra appears as one and also appears as many, so also Lord is one and appears as many. Says Viratma, Vishvatma, Viraduktah, Vishvasyatma, Tadasyatma iti. Okay. So, eka eva tu Vishvatma. Vishvatma is what? Vishvasyatma, the self of Vishva. Oh, Vishvam Atma yasya saha, or the one for whom the Vishva is the body. You know, that is called Vishvatma. So, you can call it Virat, because the whole creation is the body of Virat. Or Vishvatma meaning the one who is the essence of the whole Vishva, the self of Vishva. Saha vastutaha advaya vastvatma bhi Maya Jagan Mohayan Samasti Vyastitam Yadi. That one Atma alone, by creating the Moha, appears as Samasti and Vyasti. Appears as individual, appears as total. Yatha Kumbho Nina Lohitadimani Samsargat Tattadrupo Dushyate Tatha Ityartha. Just as the Kumbha appears to be of different color depending upon the mani or the gem in vicinity of which it is, similarly also. Uktamartam smrutya samartayate abhinnayate. Abhinnayeva bhutatma pratibhuta samaptitah ekada mohodachaiva drushyate jalachandravat. This is a quotation from Smruti. Ekaivan vish bhutatma bhute bhute vyavasthitah ekada bahudachaiva drushyate jalachandra. This is the Yoga Vasishtha quotation is restated here. Bhutanamatma vastuvritya eko abhisan ekada sarveshu bhuteshu khandado gotvavat samapya vartamana bahuda drushyate. Just as gotva, the cowness, manifests itself totally in every cow, so also this Lord manifests himself in every living being or in everything, every name and form. Tattat jalapatreshu ekadha ekadham pratibhimvitas chandra bahudha gammede tatha. Just as, so this chandra, who is one, appears as many in jalapatra, so also one prajapati, one atma, appears as many devatas. This is how can one be many? For that the quotations and illustrations are given. So this is how the Vatikakara explains this passage. This one statement of Bhashyakara has led him to write such a long thesis to explain how this is Ninda of the Kevala Yajnika, and that also is for the Stuti of Atma, who is non-dual, or the knowledge of non-duality. This is praised by condemning as though the knowledge of the duality or the conclusion of duality. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashyakrutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. 173, we chant the mantra 6. Asetya Bhyamanthata Samukhacha Yoner Hasta Bhyancha Agnimasrujata Tasma Deta Dubhayamalo Kamanantarat Antarataha Alomakahi Yonirantarataha Tadjadidamahuhu Amumyajeti Ekaikam Devam Etyasyaiva Savisrushtihi Esha Bhukhyeva Sarve Devaha Athayat Kinchedamardram Tadretaso Srijada Taduso Maha Etavadva Idam Sarvam Annam Chaivan Nadascha Soma Evannam Agnirannadah Saisha Brahmanoti Srishtihi Yachreyaso Devana Srijada Athayanmartya Sanna अमृतान सृजत तस्माद् अतिसृष्टिः अतिसृष्ट्यां अस्यैतस्यां भवति य एवं वेद। सो वार्तिककार, यस्टर्डे वी डिस्कस्ड वार्तिक हाउ दिस स्टेटमेंट तदिदं तद्यत् इदम् आहुः अमुं यज इति एकैकं देवं यदि केवल याज्ञिकः ऑल द कर्मकांडी से केवल याज्ञिकः मीनिंग दोज हु आर जस्ट डिवोटेड टू यज्ञ दे से इदम् इंद्रं यज एवं अग्निं यज मे वर्शिप दिस देवता इंद्र एंड सो फोर्थ एकैकं मीनिंग दे टेक दिस देवतास एज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम वन अनदर तन्न तद् मुमुक्षुभिः न आदरणीयम् मुमुक्षुस् डू शुड नॉट एक्सेप्ट दैट। सो दिस स्टेटमेंट हियर इज इंटरप्रेटेड एज निंदा निंदा ऑफ व्हाट दिस भेद दृष्टि नॉट निंदा ऑफ कर्म और कर्मकांडी बट निंदा ऑफ भेद दृष्टि व्हाई इज इट सो एतस्यामेव सा विसृष्टिः द रीजन इज दैट दिस होल विसृष्टि ऑफ द क्रिएशन इज ऑफ प्रजापति एंड द प्रजापति इज ओनली डेइटी And therefore, to take this devatas as different from one another is not recognizing the truth. And it is one thing to take the devatas as different from one another for the sake of worship. But if that is taken to be the ultimate truth, then that should not be accepted as the ultimate truth. Esha uhyeva sarve devaha. In fact, it is this Prajapati who indeed is all the devatas. And this was discussed at certain length yesterday. Now continuing the discussion, before going to explain the next srishti of Soma, as the Upanishad says, then Prajapati created Soma, meaning the moon, from retas, from the seed. So whatever is the fluid is nothing but moon, and that is the food, and whatever is fire is that is the eater, and the whole creation consists of the food and the eater of the food. This is what the creation is. For the purpose of meditation upon the creation. As we said, to see a certain harmony that obtains in the creation, this is being said. Now before taking that up, Bhashyakara raises a point here, a very interesting and an important point on the page 178. Says Anandagiri in the second paragraph, Ajnadayo devaha sarve prajapatihe vaidyuktam. So it is said in the earlier discussion that all the devatas, namely Agni and whatever, Agni and then Indra and then Vasu, Pushan and all the devatas who are called Anugrahakaha, meaning those who favor, all of them are Prajapati Evaiti Uktam. Etasyahi is Visrushtihi Esha Visrushtihi Esha Uhyeva Sarve Devaha. In this manner it was said that Prajapati indeed is all the devatas. Samprati तत् स्वरूप निर्दिधारिषया तत्र विप्रतिपत्तिम् दर्शयति संप्रति नाउ तत् स्वरूप निर्दिधारिषया निर्धारितुम् इच्छया विद डिजायर टू एसर्टेन द स्वरूप ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ प्रजापति हु इज दिस प्रजापति इन ऑर्डर टू एसर्टेन द नेचर ऑफ प्रजापति तत्र विप्रतिपत्तिम् दर्शयति तत्र with reference to the nature of Prajapati, Vipratipattihi, these various opinions. So various contradictory opinions are obtained with reference to the nature of Prajapati. Darshayati, Bhashyakara first presented, not various but two in fact, two opinions that obtain with reference to the nature of Prajapati are first presented by Bhashyakara in order to ascertain what is the true nature of Prajapati. See footnote number 12. Vipratipattimiti yadyapi prajapatehi samsaritva asamsaritve siddhante vishyede. So these are the two opinions about Prajapati. Whether Prajapati is a samsari or asamsari. Whether he is a jiva or he is paramatma. What exactly is Prajapati? These are the two pakshas that are raised by Bhashyakara to ascertain what is his nature. And it will be said, in Siddhanta it will be said, that Prajapati can be looked upon both as Jiva as well as Brahman. With reference to Upadhi, he can be looked upon as Jiva sometimes, but even with reference to Upadhi, actually he can be looked upon as Saguna Brahma. And with reference to his true nature, definitely Prajapati is Param Brahma. So this is how the Siddhanta is going to be. Therefore, Siddhanta accepts Prajapati both as Jiva as well as Ishvara. Therefore, these are not Vipratipattis, really speaking, these two opinions are really in concurrence with Siddhanta. So you cannot say that there are Viruddha Pratipatti or there are contradictory opinions, because both these contradictory opinions are accepted in Siddhanta. Then who is this human being? He is Jiva as well as Brahma. With reference to Upadhi, he is Jiva. With reference to his true nature, he is Brahma. Both these opinions are accepted in Vedanta Siddhanta. Therefore, it is not Vipratipatti. However, if somebody thinks that he is Jiva alone and not Brahma, or is Brahma alone and not Jiva, then the question of Vipratipatti. Meaning, if people hold only to one opinion, then it becomes a contradictory opinion. So says the Tika, Parantu Param Vipratipattaraha Tu Anichchantaha Tadvarayanteva Iti Visheshaiti Dhyayam. But Vipratipattaraha, the people who present these contradictory opinions, that anichchantaha, they do not accept this Siddhanta that Prajapati can be looked upon both as Jiva and Ishvara, that Siddhanta they do not accept. Tadvarayanti. And therefore, they want to say that Prajapati is either this or that, and Siddhanta want to say that Prajapati is this as well as that. This is Vedanta. So Vedanta never says no to anything, you know. So this is also okay, that is also okay. Or whatever it is. Therefore, there is a tremendous confusion. We want always decision, either this or that. Understand that each one is a standpoint. Jiva is a standpoint. Param Brahma is also a standpoint. If you don't accept this, if you don't see this fact, you will always get totally entangled in life. One may get a satisfaction out of believing that my opinion is right and therefore I am okay, I am comfortable. But that is merely make-believe, or that is merely deluding oneself to believe that a given opinion is right or perfect. If any opinion is perfect, it must be truth, which there is nothing. And therefore, that one can hold an opinion which is necessary in order to conduct vyavahara. But one should know the limitations of that opinion. In science, they call it boundary conditions. That any statement that is made always has a boundary condition. Any law or the rule of science also, when it is stated, There are always limitations that within these boundary conditions these laws are applicable. That's all. There is nothing that applies in every case, in every situation. That's why they came up with what we call the theory of relativity. Therefore, Vedantin says that you cannot say that this is not so. And you cannot say, they don't say this is so. You know, about the creation they will say, you cannot say that it is real. Had it been real, it cannot be negated. You cannot say it is not existent. Had it not been non-existent, it cannot be perceived. So, asat-chet na pratiyeta. Sat-chet na badhyeta. Asat-chet na pratiyeta. Had it been real, then certainly there is no badha. Meaning that can never be negated or falsified. Had it been unreal or non-existent, you could not perceive that. You could not experience that. The fact that you experience means there is some reality also. But that is not the whole reality. That there must be another way of looking at it also, when you find that what you experience also has a reason in your own conclusion. That you have concluded something and that's what makes you experience something so intensely or intimately. But all of these things depend upon our own conclusions. Anyway, people don't want that. Vipratipattana, they don't want. They want either this or that. And you tell us one. You know, which is okay. For the sake of vyavahara, one may be told one. But that kind of a mind, you know, which wants to hold on to either this or that, that mind cannot come out of this. And that mind can never appreciate truth, can never appreciate itself. That I am myself a whole bunch of full of contradictions that I don't understand myself. and that my own moods are always changing and, you know, subject to such wide variation that there can be no predictability about my own mind. And so if we want to depend upon that mind in order to judge ourselves and judge the world, it's not going to work. That's why we call Shruti as a Pramanam and not our own mind or this Tarka. Why so much is being said against Tarka? When Bhashyakara has something against the Tarkikas or against the Tarka or the method of reasoning? Not at all. However, don't simply depend upon the reasoning as the ultimate proof or ultimate Pramanam. Shruti is a Pramanam. And then you also develop the reasoning that is in keeping with the Shruti. So that is the whole point that will be made here. That's all. The only point that will be made and again is being made. So says Bhashyara. Atra vipratipadyante para eva hiranyagarbha ityeke samsari kyapare. Atra prajapati swarupe vipratipadyante. With reference to the nature of prajapati, here is vipratipatti, meaning this viparita or viruddha pratipatti. These contradictory opinions are there with reference to, contradictory conclusions are there, or notions are there, conclusions are there with reference to the nature of Prajapati. Says Anandagiri, Hiranyagarbhasya, so para eva Hiranyagarbhaiti eke vipratipattaraha. Some people hold the opinion that Prajapati is the ultimate truth. That Prajapati is the ultimate truth. Now that is right as well as wrong. If you say that Prajapati is ultimate truth as he is, as a creator or as whatever we find with reference to Upadhi, if you consider him as the ultimate truth, that Vedanta does not accept. So those people who accept that Saguna Brahma is ultimate truth, that's not right. That Saguna Brahma is ultimate truth with reference to his nature, which is beyond all the gunas. And therefore, those people who want to accept that Prajapati as such is ultimate truth, there is nothing beyond Prajapati, well, that would not be accepted by us. So some people say that Prajapati is the ultimate truth. Paraha means Brahmaiva Gahiranyagarbhaiti eke. Some people say that Prajapati or Hiranyagarbha is indeed Brahma. In fact, one meaning of the word of Brahma is Hiranyagarbha also. Samsari iti apare. Other people say that this Hiranyagarbha Prajapati is samsari. Siddhanagiri, Hiranyagarbhasya paratvam adye. Dvitiye kalpe samsaritvam vidheyamiti vibhaga. Naturally. So first people say that Hiranyagarbha is Parambrahma. Other people say that Hiranyagarbha is samsari. Tatra purupaksham grunnati. Purma is the prathama paksha. What is the prathama paksha? That is what is accepted to begin with. So what do these people say? So Vashyakara accepts their paksha and elaborates that Hiranyagarbha is Param Brahma. That is what they say, which is what Vashyakara presents here. This is Vashya. Para evatu mantra varanat indram mitram varunam agnimahuhu. Iti esha brahma esha indraha esha prajapatihi ete sarve devaha iti shrutehe. Parha eva tu mantra varanat, because this mantra say that, so this mantra says that Hiranyagarbha is in fact Paramatma. Indram mitram varunam agnim ahuhu iti. Putnana basa indram iti paramatmanameva indradinamabhi ahuhu ityardha. So sages call this paramatma is indra or mitra or varuna or agni. So this paramatma Hiranyagarbha alone is called indra, mitra, varuna, agni by the sages. And then we say that Hiranyagarbha is the ultimate truth. Esha Brahma, Esha Indraha, Esha Prajapatihi, Ete Sarve Devaha, Ete Shrutehe. Here is the statement from Aitareya Upanishad. where it is said, Esha Brahma, this Atma indeed is Brahma. No means Hiranyagarbha. Esha Indra, he is Indra. Esha Prajapati, he is Prajapati, the creator. Ete Sarve Devaha, this Atma alone is all this Devata. This is what Aitareya Upanishad says. So, that mantra as well as this Brahmana, Aitareya Upanishad, all of both of them say that Hiranyagarbha Prajapati is indeed Paramatma. Meaning, Paramatma alone is called Prajapati. So what we are calling Prajapati is indeed Paramatma. Nanu ekasya anekatmakatvam mantravaranat avagamyate nanu paramatmatvam prajapatahiti ashankhya indram maranam indram mitram varanam agnimahuhu. That mantravarana seems to say that one Paramatma is many or one deity is many. Nanu paramatmatvam prajapatahe. That mantra does not seem to say that Prajapati is Paramatma. Indra, Mitra, Varuna, Agni, that's what they call him. That means there is one Devata who is many, but that doesn't mean that Prajapati is Paramatma. Iti Ashankhya Brahmana Vakya Mudaharati. So, now Brahmana Vakya Aitareya Upanishad was said, Esha Brahma, Esha Indra, Esha Prajapati. So, a very clear statement that this Paramatma alone is Prajapati. So, Brahma Prajapati Sutra Virajau. Brahma is Sutra and Prajapati is Virat. This is how it is. Sutra means Hiranyagarbha and Prajapati is Virat. Esha Shabda Paramatma Shaha. Esha Brahma means this Paramatma is Brahma. Then Bhashyakara says, Svrateshcha Etameke Vadantyagnim Manumanye Prajapatim Ite Yosavatindriyo Grahya Sukshmo Vyaktas Sanatanaha Sarvabhutamayo Chintyaha Saeva Swamudbabhau Itisha. So Smudayascha. From the Smriti statement, from the Manusmriti, the two statements are quoted, that from the Smriti also we can say that Prajapati is Paramatma. How? Etameke vadantyagnim manum anye prajapatim. Etam Paramatmanam. This Paramatma eke agnim vadanti. Some people say that this Paramatma alone is Agni. Manu manye, some people call him Manu. Prajapati manye, and some people call him Prajapati. So he alone is Agni, he alone is Manu, he alone is Prajapati. So what is Prajapati? Is this Paramatma alone. This is what Manusmriti says. And also, Yaha sau atindriyaha agrahyaha sukshmaha avyaktaha sanadanaha sarvabhutamayaha achintyaha saeva swayam udbhav iti. Yah Paramatma asu atindriyah. So say Dhanagari, karmendriya avishayatvam atindriyatvam. This Paramatma indriya is beyond the scope of the organs of action, meaning he cannot be grasped or attained by the organs of action. Agrahyah agrahyatvam jnanendriya avishayatvam. He cannot be grahya, means he cannot be perceived also by the organs of perception. Sukshmaha, why is it so? Because he is sukshmaha avyaktaha. He is subtle, he is a very subject. Avyakta is unmanifest and therefore he cannot be attained by the organs of action nor can he be perceived by the organs of perception. Then somebody may think that he is not there at all. If you can't see him, you cannot feel him, if you cannot experience him or you cannot grasp him, then he is not there. He says, no. Nachatasya sattvam Pramatradi bhava abhava sakshitvena sada sattva. Here Pramatra means antahkaram. Najatasya sattvam. Don't say that this Paramatma is, this entity is non-existent. Because he is there. How is he there? Pramatradi bhava abhava sakshitvena. He is very sakshi, the witness of Pramatma means antahkaranam. Whether antahkaran is there, he is a sakshi. Antahkaranam is not there, is in deep sleep, that also is a sakshi. So this principle or Paramatma is Sakshi or the witness of the presence and absence of Antahkaranam. in the waking and dream states, Antahkarana is present, he is a Sakshi. Deep sleep state is absent, he is a Sakshi. So he is Sanatana. Sadasattva. Sanatana means Chirantana, the one who is ever there. Whether Antahkarana is there or not, one who is ever there is called Sanatana. Itascha tasya na asatvam sarvesham atmatvadityah sarvabhutamayah. And also for this other is further reason why we say that Paramatma or this one who is described here is not non-existent, because he is the very self of all the beings. Sarvabhutamayah, he is the self of all the beings. Antahkarana avishyatvah achintyah, the one who cannot be comprehended by the mind. Naturally, because mind can comprehend something that is within the scope of limitation. See, mind is a product of this time and space, and mind can only comprehend something within the range, scope of time and space, not beyond that. If mind has to perceive something or conceive or visualize something, it will do that with reference to space, in reference to some form, with reference to some dimension, with reference to some quality. Meaning the mind can never go beyond the time and space with reference to its visualization. Mind is the instrument of knowledge of even that which is beyond the time and space. But when that mind itself gives up the concept of time and space, then it becomes an instrument of knowledge of that. But as long as mind functions within, you know, as long as the mind also is functioning or attempting within the range of time and space, attempting to visualize or experience something, so long it remains beyond the purview of the mind, beyond the scope of the mind. So achintya in that sense. Not that he cannot be known. Yes, he can be known as the very self, but not in a conventional manner that we know a ghatapata, etc. Meaning that we know him as an object of the mind. He is to be known as a very subject of the mind, as a witness of the mind, but known definitely. Yosu Paramatma Yathokta Visheshana Saiva Svayam Viradatmana Bhutavanityityaha. Yosu Paramatma, this Paramatma, Yathokta Visheshanaha, one who is of this nature, Atindriyaha, Agrahyaha, Avyaktaha, Sanatanaha, Sarvabhutamayaha, Achintyaha, Paramatma, such as this, Sahaiva, Swayam Viradatmana, Bhutavan. That Paramatma himself manifested as the Virat. So, Sahaiva, Swayam Udbabhav, Ud plus Bhu. So Udbhav, he came into existence, or he came into manifestation himself. So it's called Swayambhu. So he himself comes to manifestation as Hiranyagarbha Prajapati. He himself goes into unmanifestation and is beyond both manifestation and unmanifestation. That Paramatma is both beyond the manifest and unmanifest, nevertheless comes to manifestation as Hiranyagarbha and again goes back to the unmanifest as what we call Ishvara. He is Paramatma. Therefore, this Smriti also very clearly say that what we call Prajapati is none other than Paramatma himself. Siddhanandagiri, Mantra Brahmana Smritishu Parasya Sarvadevatatma Drushtehe Atracha Sutrasya Tat Pratidehe Tasya Paratvam Iti Uktam. Mantra Brahmana Smritishu. So mantra varna from Rigveda, the mantra was quoted. Brahmana Aitareya Upanishad was quoted. Smriti, Manusmriti was quoted. Parasya Sarvadevata Atmatva Drushtehe. That Param Brahma alone is Sarvadevata. Atraja Sutrasya Tat Pratidehe. Atra meaning Tadyad Idamahuhu iti Prakrita Vakye. Tadyad idamahu amumyaja amumyaja. There also we find that the same Prajapati who is Indra, Agni and whatever. So atraja sutrasya tat pratidehe. Here also we find that sutra or Prajapati is indeed all the devatas. Eshaveva sarve devaha. There also is very clearly stated. Sutrasya tat pratidehe means sarva devata atmatva pratidehe. The sutra indeed is sarva devata. Tasya sutrasya paratvam iti uktam. Therefore we say that sutra Hiranyagarbha Prajapati is Paramatma. Idanim purupakshantaramaha. Now, purupakshantara. Both are purupakshas. in as much as first Purvapaksha and second Purvapaksha. Each of this Paksha, because it holds on to just one opinion, therefore it is called Purvapaksha. Siddhanta is that which will reconcile between the two. But in as much as this Vipratipattara, they hold on to one of them as the ultimate, therefore both are Purvapaksha. First Purvapaksha and Purvapakshantaram, the second Purvapaksha is stated. Samsariya Vedi, says Bhashyakara. Samsariya Vasyat, or let us say the other opinion is that Prajapati of Hiranyagarbha is Samsari. Why is it so? Because Prajapati said to the state, that is attained as a result of the Upasanas. So here we were told that Hiranyagarbha, the Prajapati state, that is attained as a result of the Upasana, as a result of this Jnana Karma Samuchya or pure Upasana. And so it was said, Sarvan Papmanah Aushada Iti Shrutehe. Then how did that Yajmana or the Upasaka attain the state of Prajapati? By burning or destroying all the papa of the nature of the obstacles. Anything that is an obstacle to the nature of Prajapati, all the obstacles were burned by the Upasaka, and therefore he became Prajapati. So one who was a Yajamana or Upasaka himself became Prajapati. That's all. Okay. So Sarvan Papmanaha Aushada, he burned all the papas. Then Anandagiri says here, Sarva Papma Daha Shravana Matrena Katham Prajapati Samsaritvam Tatraha. Just because this one who became Prajapati or this Prajapati, he burned all his sins, therefore how do we say that he is Samsari? So the explanation is given by Purvapakshi, says, Nahi Asamsarinaha Papmadaha Prasangosti Ayardi Sanyoga Sharvanacha Athayan Martyasan Amrutana Sujada Ipicha. Hiranyagarbham Pashyati Jayamanam Iti Cha Mantra Varna. Nahi Asamsarinaha Papmadaha Prasangasti. If Hiranyagarbha were asamsari, then there would be no question of any papa. That we are told there, Prajapati is the one who burnt all his papa. That means that he had papa and therefore he is samsari. Otherwise, papa cannot be in a samsari. Nahi asamsarinaha papmadaha prasanga asti. For a samsari, there is no question of burning of the sins. Then says Anandagiri, antaha tad dharma upadeshaditi yatra parasyabhi sarapapmo dayangikarat na idam samsaritve lingam. See, this statement says that Prajapati is devoid of all the papa. That is, devoid of all the papa is not a linga for calling him samsari. In fact, that is a linga for a samsaritvam. Sarvan papmanah aushada. He burnt all the papa, meaning he is sinless. So sinlessness is supposed to be the attribute or the, you know, is the description of a samsari paramatma. And how does antaha tad dharma upadeshaditiyatra? See footnote number 8. This is sutra, Brahma Sutra, which we have studied in course of the study of Chandogya Upanishad. And that came in the first chapter and the first quarter, where the first Brahmalinga Vakyas were being discussed. And so in Chandogya Upanishad, various statements of Upasana, all of them were taken up there to show that what is being meditated upon or worshipped is in fact Param Brahma. So even though what we worship is a certain form or a certain appearance or a manifestation of nature, it is none other than Paramatma alone. That is how one should know. Even though you meditate on Lord Shiva as a form or Narayana as a form, one should know that it is Param Brahma who is in this form, and not thinking that this is ultimate form. So that is the point that is being made in Brahma Sutra, and that's the point that Bhashyakara always wants to make, that just because we worship the form, we should not forget that the fact that this form, through this form, the one who is worshipped is Param Brahma indeed. So that was the idea that Antaha. So one who is mentioned as Antaha. Tad Dharmopadeshat says footnote number 8. Anta Shabdartha Paramatma Bhavitumarhati. That sutra has been explained that what is meant by the word Anta should be understood as Paramatma. Why do we say Atra Hetu? Sutra always gives, makes a pratignya and gives a Hetu. Antaha is a pratignya. Meaning Anta Shabdartha Paramatma Bhavitumarhati. The one who is meant by the word Anta should reasonably be Paramatma. Why so? Tad Dharmopadesha, that's the Hetu. What is meant by, what is the meaning of that? Tad means Tasya, Parameshwarasya, Yesaro Pap Marahityadi Dharmaha, Tesham Asmin Vakya Upadesha, the Hetvartha. Tad Dharmopadesha, that Vakya is explained like this. That Tasya Parameshwarasya, Ye Pap Masaro Pap Marahityadi Dharmaha, that Parameshwara, in that particular Vakya in Chandogya Upanishad, that principle which is to be meditated upon is described as one who is free from all the sins. And so this and other dharmas which are described, which are mentioned there, these are the dharmas that belong to Param Brahma. So Sarva Papa Maraha Ityadi Dharmaha, the dharmas attributes such as being free from all the sins, Tesham Asmin Vakya Upadeshat, all the dharmas which primarily belong to Paramatma, they are being mentioned here. Therefore we say that the one who is referred to in this, in the Upasana, is Param Brahma. What is the Vakya? Athaya Esho Antaha Aditya, the one who is Aditya Antaha, the one who is within this Aditya. So in Chandogya Upanishad, the Upasana is of sun. And sun means the one who is the self of the sun, the one who is the very essence of sun, S-U-N, sun. Aditya Antaha, one who is the very Atma of the Aditya. Who is he? Hiranmayaha. Then you meditate upon a Purusha who is in Aditya. And the description of that Purusha also is given. Hiranmayaha, one who is golden. Hiranmayaha Purushaha Drushyade. This person or man with golden hue that we find in Aditya. Dhesada Savitramandala Madhyavarti Narayanaha Sarasijasana Sannivishtaha Keyurvan Makara Kundalavan Kiridi Hari Hiranmaya Vapuhu Sdhruta Shankha Chakraha. Hiranmaya Vapuhu. So one whose Vapu of the body is Hiranmaya. So that is how you meditate upon Narayana as the self of this Aditya or the Surya. But that Narayana is not to be taken as a person, is none other than Param Brahma. So Param Brahma, since it is beyond the comprehension of the mind, it is brought in the comprehension of the mind by assigning certain attributes. And that is how you can meditate upon Brahma. And so one who is meditated upon is Param Brahma. Hiranmaya Purushaha Drushyate Hiranyash Mashruhu, having golden moustache. Hiranyakeshaha, having golden hair. Pranakhat Sarva Eva Suvarnaha, beginning from Nakha, beginning from the nails, you know. So the whole body is made up of gold. So one should meditate upon Narayana or Param Brahma or the Purusha who is in Aditya and who is of this description and who is devoid of all the papa, etc. So that Vakya, Shruti Hyasya Sutrasya Vishaya, with reference to that Vakya of the Shruti, there was this question whether this Purusha is Paramatma or not. And the opinion is, or the conclusion is, that Antaha, he is Paramatma, Tad Dharmopadeshat. Because about this Purusha, the dharmas that are actually mentioned, or dharmas that are enjoined or indicated, all of those dharmas belong to Paramatma, therefore he is Paramatma. Well, that is just mentioned here, by the way. Antastad Dharmopadeshad Yatra. In that sutra, Parasyabhi Sarvapapmodaya Angikarat. There, Parabrahma also is said to be Sarvapapmodaya. Udaya is Asamsargaha. That Paramatma is devoid of all the sins. That is what it is said. And here also it is said that Prajapati is devoid of all the sins. Therefore, to be devoid of all the sins is not a linga for jiva. In fact, it can very well be Paramatma. So therefore, na idam samsaritva lingam iti ashankyaha bhayarati sanyoga shravana. Purupakshi says, they're all right. Bhaya arati sanyoga shravana cha. So vibhet sanayvareve. So when you say that, he is endowed with bhaya and arati. Therefore, he is jiva. And also, asayan matyasan amrutan asrujata. Right in this mantra itself, this kandika said that Prajapati, who is mortal, created devatas who are immortal. Amrutan means devan asrujata iticha. So, this Prajapati is called your what? Martyah. In this kandika itself, Prajapati is called Martyah, means a jiva. So, asrujata iticha shravana. That is how you should add that. This is also what we find as mentioned by the Shruti. Na kevalam martyatva shrudehe eva samsaritvam kintu janma shrudescha iti. And that Hiranyagarbha has birth. He is martya. He is subject to death. And he has a birth also. Who is samsari? One is subject to birth and death. And Prajapati here is said as martya, meaning subject to mrityu. And also elsewhere is said to be subject to birth. Hiranyagarbham paschita jayamanam or paschati jayamanam. So who is paschati? Paramatma paschati. Paramatma jayamanam Hiranyagarbham paschati. Paramatma sees Hiranyagarbha, who is being born. Meaning Paramatma is a witness of Hiranyagarbha that is being born. So Hiranyagarbha is subject to birth. So, and Martyah is also subject to death. Therefore, he is samsari. Iti cha mantra varanat yathokta hetu naam samsari eva asyadati pratignya anvayah. Okay. So all of these Shruti statements indeed confirm that Prajapati or Hiranyagarbha is samsari. Nansit Anandagiri, karma phala darshana adhikare brahma ityadhyayaha smradesya tat phala bhutasya prajapadehe samsaritvame vaidyaha. So, karma phala darshanadhikare, footnote number 11, karma phalasya darshanam yatra tadrashi prakarane karma kande. So, karma phala darshana adhikare, in a prakarana or the section where the phala or the result of karma is being described, in Manusmriti, there is a chapter which describes, there is describing the glory of karma. So what all you can attain as a result of karma, that is the subject matter of description in the Smriti. So while discussing the adhikara, discussing the karma phala, what can be the exalted result of this karma? In that section, karma phala adhikare, karma phala darshana adhikare, brahma ityadhyaha smritescha. And also in the Smriti which begins with brahma, again the Manusmriti, tatphalabhutasya prajapadehe samsaritvam. Tatphalabhutasya karmaphalabhutasya prajapadi is described by Manusmriti as a result of a certain karma and upasana. This Shruti also says, Manusmriti also says that. Prajapadehe samsaritvam eva. So we say that Prajapati is indeed samsari. So the Manusmriti is quoted here. Says Vashagara, Smriteshcha karma vipaka prakriyayam brahma vishvasujo dharma mahanavyaktamevacha uttamam sattviki metam gati mahur manishinah. Uttamam sattvikim etam gatim ahuhu manishinah. Manishinah ahuhu. The wise say that this is uttamam sattvikim etam gatim. Sattvikim, so sattva parinama jnana karma phala bhutam. that this is the highest attainment as a result of the performance of upasana and karma. This is what the gati means, ultimate the result. This is what the great people, the wise people say. For footnote number 4 said, karma ityadi karma phala prakarane. Karma vipaka prakriya means karma phala prakarane. Tathaj tatrasthasvudhi nahi asamsaru phalam vaktumarhati bhavaha. So this smruti, manasmruti, which obtains in the section which discusses karma phala, naturally where it mentions prajapati also as a result of karma phala, therefore it cannot talk about, I mean, naturally it cannot be unless prajapati is samsari, otherwise he cannot be within the scope of karma phala. So brahma you can become by karma and upasana, one can become brahma. Virat is brahma, it, you know, so brahma is Virat. Vishvasrujaha, meaning Manu and others who are the Prajapatis, you know, those who create. So Manu is the Prajapati. So if Brahma is Virat, and then Manu etc. are Prajapati, that also you can become. Dharma, Tadabhivanini, Devata, Yamaha, or Yamaraja is called Dharma. So who is the one who is responsible for the law, and the, in, you know, the proper dispensing of the karma phala with reference, you know, in accordance with the karma is Dharma. Mahan, Mahan Prakrutehe Adya Vikara Sutram. Here it means Hiranyagarbha, which is the first modification of Prakruti. Avyaktam, Avyaktam Prakrutehi Tibhedaha. I mean, this is what they say. You can even become Prakruti, which is even beyond Hiranyagarbha. Uttamam Satvikimetam Gatimahur. Meaning, all of these are within the realm of attainment as a result of karma and upasana. This is what Manusmriti says. Therefore also we say that Prajapati, which is a result of the performance of karma and upasana, must be a samsari, because it is karma phala. It is something that is attained, and what is attained has to be limited, because it is going to be for a limited period of time. And when the adhikara goes away, then again he will lose that pada. This is how we understand. So both these things are there, you know, and therefore sometimes, as you said in the Puranas also, Indra, etc., devatas are described as nothing. It's like that. Indra is described as nobody. He is described as a greedy person. He is a, you know, devata is a greedy and insecure. That's how we find. And some other places where Indra is described as the greatest one, you know, when you find his description. So we don't know what to make out of all this. In Puranas, in the Smriti, in the Vedas, everywhere, we don't know what to make out of this. And so this is a very relevant question. We have to settle that in our mind, you know, that we don't know how to relate with these devatas. Even Hiranyagarbha, Prajapati, Virat, Hiranyagarbha, if everybody is also within, so this, if you can become that, looks like they are all within the realm of samsara. So what to make out of all of this? See the Anandagiri on the page 180. Evam Purupakshaitva Siddhanta Idum Prasangamaha. This is the Purupakshas are there, and so therefore there is a prasanga or occasion for Siddhanta. So Anagiri Astutarahi Anyatara Pakshe Nirnayaka Bhava. Both Pakshas seem to be very valid, and therefore you cannot really come to any conclusion about both of them. Both of them should be equally strong. Every Paksha is like that. Do the women have Adhikara in Vedas or not? You can debate forever. Do they have Adhikara in Gayatri or not? Go on and on forever, you know. Have only Brahmanas adhikaris for Vedas, or other Varanas also have adhikara or not? Go on. Can only Brahmanas become sannyas, or others also can become? You will find reference of everything everywhere, because so many Shrutis, so many Smrutis, so many Puranas, that you can always find something somewhere. And the debates can go on. And therefore, an ordinary person to hear, even a Mumukshu gets confused, you know. And therefore, so necessary to come to a certain understanding about this issue. So since Nirnayaka, therefore since we cannot come to a conclusion about, you know, both of them seem to be equally right, and therefore we cannot come to a Nirnayaka or a conclusion, therefore there is a occasion now to come to Siddhanta or an understanding about what is Vedanta Siddhanta. Astu tarhi dvividha vakya vashat prajapatehe samsaritvam asamsaritvam cha. Alright, since both these kinds of vakyas are there, therefore let us say that Prajapati is samsari as well as samsari. But that is impossible. In your mind you cannot imagine these two contradictory things. That's the problem with the mind. That it cannot, it can only take one paksha at a time. It cannot take two pakshas, you know. Either samsari, because of a poor mind, can only assume one form at a time. Either samsari or a samsari. Satya or asatya, that's all. So this mithya goes beyond the comprehension of the mind. Mithya is both satya or asatya, or neither satya nor asatya, and therefore the mind is flabbergasted then. In America there is the expression mind-boggling, you know. So this is all mind-boggling. Everything is mind-boggling. This is a scam also is mind-boggling. All these worldly things are mind-boggling. But here, everything is mind-boggling. That you cannot just comprehend in your mind. It is not right to say that Prajapati is both samsari as well as a samsari, because well, how will you in your mind look upon him? You cannot simultaneously look upon him as samsari or a samsari. Then you will just take the convenient paksha, and that also is not right. So there must be an ascertainment there. There must be a certain conclusion. Mahasankhya Athayati. So Mahasankhya says, अथ एवं विरुद्धार्थानुपत्तेः प्रामाण्यव्याघातः इति चेत् न. सो दिस् इस् पूर्वपक्षः. पूर्वपक्ष इस् दिस् अथ एवं विरुद्ध अर्थ अनुपत्तेः. एवं विरुद्ध अर्थ अनुपत्तेः, सिन्स् इस् विरुद्ध अर्थ. These contradictory conclusions or contradictory interpretations or concepts, anupatte, are not tenable, not logical. Meaning the mind cannot comprehend it with its reasoning. Pramanya vyagatah. So both the shrutis become a pramana. Each one contradicts the other one. So one will dismiss the other one. Because shruti can dismiss shruti. When there was a question of battle between shruti and smruti, then we say that smruti is knocked out by shruti. But when there are two shruti statements, then each one will knock out the other, and therefore each one becomes negated by the other. So pramanya vyaghatah iti chet. So we would say that both the shrutis lose their pramanyam. If this is so, then answer is no, that is not so. Now here you can see that asterisk there, and you can the footnote. अथैव इत्यादि उपपद्यते इत्यंत भाष्यम् भाष्ये इमानि पञ्चवार्तिकानि द्रष्टव्यानि. सो दिस फाइव वार्तिकास आर देयर टू एक्सप्लेन अथ एवं अप टू ओ उपपद्यते अप टू दैट पॉइंट. देन वी शुड रीड द नेक्स्ट स्टेटमेंट आल्सो. ओके, भाष्यकार सेज हियर आनंदगिरि तद्विविध वाक्य श्रवणानंतर्यम अथ शब्दार्थ. अथ मीन्स व्हाट? व्हेन बोथ द काइंड्स ऑफ वाक्यस आर देयर, हैविंग नाउ लुक्ड एट द मीनिंग ऑफ बोथ दिस वाक्यस व्हिच सीम टू प्रेजेंट कॉन्ट्रडिक्टरी मीनिंग. अथ एवं शब्द संसारित्व असंसारित्व प्रकार परामर्शार्थ. एंड एवं शब्द मीन्स दैट प्रजापति कैन बी संसारी और असंसारी. बोथ ऑफ दीज पॉसिबिलिटीज आर देयर. विरोध कृतम अप्रामाण्यम निराकरोति. भाष्यकार says no, even though the shrutis appear to be contradicting each other, they are not contradicting. In fact, that is the whole pravritti of Brahma Sutra. All sutras, Jaimini sutras also, the Purva Mimamsa sutras are also to reconcile, but they are to explain also. Brahma sutras are primarily to explain the vakyas and to reconcile the apparent contradictions. So this Bhashya and the Prakarana Granthas also do the same thing. And so Virodha Kritam Apramanyam Nirakaroti, that even though the Shrutis appear to expound or appear to teach us the contradictory things, in fact that is not so. See Ananagiri, Svata Samsaritvam Kalpanayacha Samsaritvam इति कल्पनांतर संभवा. दैट्स ऑल. सो वेदांतिन्स ऑलवेज हैव दिस रेडीमेड आंसर. स्वतः असंसारित्वम एंड कल्पनाया च स्वतः असंसारित्वम कल्पनाया च संसारित्वम whether you like it or not this is what it is and therefore we have to one day settle this in our own mind it is not their opinion it should become our opinion or our understanding until then it only appears to be theirs you know so every time we have a problem they seem to come out with this explanation or come out with some you know and then that's all there is no problem every time you say that they always have an argument for everything you know ki bodu samjhavi to that's all right but then since these contradictions are built in everywhere mithya is that contradictions are built in everything every atom has a contradiction whether it is mass or whether it is velocity or what that is where the contradiction begins whether it is there or not it's here or there from the atom or this finest particle the contradiction begins then we find that the contradiction is the very material cause of the creation and therefore we say that anirvachaniya avidya is the material cause you know the scientists will accept this anirvachaniyatva means ajnanam so from there look at the finest particle electron and the scientists are baffled with that you know that's why they come out with this probability probability is this or probability is that probability is or probability is not so the probability of its being is this and not being is that and so from there the contradictions begin so we must know that the contradiction appears to be the truth of this life that means that you should not hold on to any particular thing otherwise you'll be stuck and so swatah asamsaritvam hiranyagarbha from its you know as far as the truth is concerned na cha matsani bhutani he will say that nothing is in me therefore I am a samsari kalpanaya cha samsaritvam matsani sarvabhutani all the beings are in me if you accept the beings they are all in me you look at me they are not there this is how the upadesha is given so kalpanaya cha samsaritvam that samsaritva itself is kalpana whether it is in hiranyagarbha or anywhere Since samsaritva itself is kalpana, therefore, wherever samsaritva is there, it is kalpana. That's all. So swadaha, in its true nature, everything and but everything is parambrahma. And samsaritva is kalpana. So whether it is hiranyagarbha, then ultimately say whether hiranyagarbha or jiva or wherever, samsaritva is always kalpana and swadaha asamsaritva. Iti kalpanantara sambhavat. Since you don't have to hold on to this kalpas, One kalpa is what? The Hiranyagarbha is asamsari. Other kalpa is what? Hiranyagarbha is samsari. These are all kalpanas. The kalpanantara of Vedanta then presents another third kalpa. Is both samsari as well as samsari. Which is contradictory. It says, well, it is not contradictory in as much as asamsari and samsari are of different degrees of reality. Therefore, they are not contradictory. I am simultaneously handsome as well as ugly so look at my reflection in the mirror it is very ugly and look at me I am handsome or whatever it is so both of these contradictory things are there except that handsomeness and ugliness are not of the same degree of reality handsomeness is the real and ugliness is unreal therefore asamsaritva is the reality about anything and samsaritva is the kalpana about anything in as much as anything is available for kalpana therefore we say that The samsaritvam hiranyagarbha is kalpana and asamsaritvam is true and this will be then extended everywhere. Idi kalpanantara sambhavat This other kalpa also is possible. Therefore, dvividha shrutinam avirodhat pramanya siddhi Therefore, these shrutis do not contradict each other and therefore both of them can be said to be pramanam. So, कल्पनया संसारत्वम् इति एतत् विषयः इति उपाधि इति ओके सो भाष्यकरः सेस् कल्पनान्तरोपपत्तेः अविरोधात् उपाधिविशेषसम्बन्धात् विशेषकल्पनान्तरमुपपद्यते कल्पनांतरोपपत्ते अविरोधा कल्पनांतर इज विकल्प दैट ए थर्ड विकल्प आल्सो इज उपपत्ते है दिस टू विकल्पास आर नॉट टेनेबल बिकॉज दे कॉन्ट्रडिक्ट ईच अदर बट ए थर्ड विकल्प आल्सो इज टेनेबल एंड देयरफॉर अविरोधा देयरफॉर दिस श्रुतीज डू नॉट कॉन्ट्रडिक्ट ईच अदर because both of them can be understood in a third manner. And therefore, kalpanaya samsaritvam, that samsaritva is kalpana. It is explained, upadhi vishesha sambandha. Same parambrahma, because of the sambandha or association with a particular upadhi, vishesha kalpanantaram upapadyate. Vishesha means samsaritva. Samsaritva kalpanantaram upapadyate. That parambrahma can be samsari also because of the association with a upadhi and swataha asamsari. This kalpana being there, therefore the shrutis they are not contradictory. Now we can take a look at the vartika. So atha evam ityadi upapadyate iti antyabhashye imani pancha vartikani drashtavyani. These five vartikas are there to explain the statement of bhashya. Tathahi, to illustrate. Mitho viruddhavadittvat dvayoragamayorapi apramanya prasaktischet na klupteyantara samsayat. Mitha viruddhavadittvat, mitha means paraspara. So since this viruddhavadittvat is both of these fellows, they contradict each other. Dvayoho agamayoho api apramanya prasaktihi chet. Therefore, if the Kurupaksha has to say that both these agamas or both the shrutis are apramanya because they contradict each other, na, then our answer is na. Why? Kluptyandara samshayat. Because klupti means kalpana or vikalpa. Kluptyandara samshayat. That there is another vikalpa also possible, that samsaritva and asamsaritva, both of them can be properly explained. Says the explanation here, evam purupakshaitva siddhantedum prasangamaha. Evam purupakshaitva, having presented this purupakshas, siddhantedum prasangamaha, that now this samshaya arises, therefore there is an occasion for mithahaiti. Swatah asamsaritvevi sutra se samsaritvam aupadhikamiti vidhantara siddhehe. That swatah asamsaritve, even though Hiranyagarbha is asamsari by himself, sutra se samsaritvam aupadhikam, his samsaritva is because of the upadhi. Iti vidhantara siddhehe. It is kalpanantara siddhehe. This kind of kalpana or other paksha also can be there. Therefore, dvid agama avirodhaiti siddhantam aha naiti, that these agamas are not contradictory to each other, that is siddhanta. So the vartikara said na kluptyantara samshayat. Klupti means kalpana, so kluptyantara samshayat, because other kalpana, namely that samsaritvam is by itself, by upadhi, asamsaritvam by swarupa, this kalpana is possible. Says he tika, कथम संसारित्व असंसारित्व विरुद्धार्थ वाक्यानाम एकत्रात्मनि प्रामाण्यमिति आशंक्य संग्रह वाक्यम विवरणोदे. कथम संसारित्व असंसारित्व विरुद्धार्थ वाक्यानाम, दिस वाक्यास विच आर अपोज टू ईच अदर, बिकॉज वन ऑफ देम सेज हिरण्यगर्भ संसारी, अदर वन सेज हिरण्यगर्भ इज संसारी, सो दिस वाक्यास विच अपीयर टू कॉन्ट्रडिक्ट ईच अदर. एकत्रात्मनि प्रामाण्यम, how can both of these contradictory vakyas be pramana or valid with reference to one atma? How can one atma be both samsari and asamsari? How can it be? Iti ashankya sangraha vakyam vivranati. That first verse is now explained by Vartikakara himself, Pratyagati. So the next verse is Pratyaga jnana ajnana janeka vividhopari sangatehe viruddhartatva vachasam स्यादेकत्रावि संभवः. प्रत्येक अज्ञानज, दैट इज बोर्न ऑफ प्रत्येक अज्ञान. अज्ञान इज इग्नोरेंस. प्रत्येक मीन्स द आत्मा. प्रत्येक अज्ञानज मीनिंग दैट विच इज बोर्न ऑफ द इग्नोरेंस ऑफ द सेल्फ. अनेक विविधोपाधि संगतेः. सो अनेक, मेनी, विविध मीन्स वेरिड, उपाधि. So many and the varied upadhis which are born as a result of the ignorance of the self, Sangate, on account of Sangati or the association with the Upadis, which are many and varied, and which Upadis are born of the ignorance of the self. Viruddha tattva vachasam syat ekatra api sambhavaha. Therefore, in ekatra, even in Hiranyagarbha is one, or rather in the Atma, Pratyekatma is one. This kind of viruddha artha, that is samsari or samsari, both these arthas are possible because of the association with the Upadi. He can be looked upon as samsari, so that is possible. Says pratyekiti samsarita iti sheshaha. Sangatehe samsarita. Pratyek agnyanaja aneka vivida upadi sangatehe samsarita. This is iti sheshaha. Svatahatu asamsarita iti angikare phalitamaha. But then svataha is asamsaritva, therefore viruddhartattva vachasam syad ekatra api sambhavah. Therefore, since he is svataha asamsari, therefore, from upadhi standpoint samsari, svataha asamsari. Viruddhartattvena pratiyamano udaharata vakyanam iti yavad. So, viruddhartattvena pratiyamano udaharata vakyanam syad ekatra api sambhavah. That, so, viruddhartattva vachasam meaning what? Viruddhartatvena pratiyamana udaharata vakyana. So vakya is a statement of the Shruti which appear to profound contradictory meaning. Both of them can be reconciled with reference to oneself alone, because whether one is from the standpoint of upadhi or one is from its own swarupa. Tesham ekasmin atmani sambhavameva sadhayan adu asamsarita vakyanam upavattimaha. How samsaritva and samsaritva, both of them are possible in one? That is what the Vartikara explains. In that process of explanation, first of all, adu asamsaritva vakyana upavattimaha. First, Vartikara explains how the vakyas that say that atma is a samsari, how they are tenable. That is first being said. Apasta vidya tajjatvat asthula dyukti gocharah. Svavasa vidyopadhi san svavasa vidyopadhi san sakshantaryamitam vraje. Apasta avidya tajjatvat. Apasta avidya tajjatvat. Atma is apasta avidya, meaning is devoid of avidya. Tajjam, meaning all the upadhis. So kama, karma and upadhis are born of avidya. Atma is in fact free from ignorance as well as all the products of ignorance ever. He is untouched by ignorance and the products of ignorance. That is why, number one. Number two, asthuladi ukti gocharaha. Asthulam, ananu, akshasvam, all of that shows atma is beyond the upadhi. Because sthula, sukshma, all of these are the nature of upadhi. When atma is described there as asthulam ananu, meaning he is beyond the upadhi. Svabhasa avidyopadhi san. So atma, who is thus devoid of ignorance and the upadhi, however, on account of being endowed with the upadhi of avidya, svabhasa avidyopadhi san, this atma, when he gets reflected in avidya, all gets reflected in the antahkaranam, which is the product of avidya, then on account of his identification with antahkaranam, sakshi antaryamitam vraje, then he, that sakshi call, is called antaryami, meaning, so sakshi, antaryami, all of these designations are there only with reference to upadhi. He himself is beyond the concepts of antaryami or sakshi, but he can be called antaryami, meaning Hiranyagarbha. Sakshi is Paramatma. So he is merely a witness, untouched by tamas of parastat, untouched by the ignorance and the products of ignorance, is nevertheless called antaryami Hiranyagarbha on account of the association with the upadhi. Okay, so says tatraiva savishesha vakyanami sambhavamaha svabhasa iti. So the first line said how he is asamsari and how by upadhi he is called antaryami, etc. Chidabhasa vishishta avidyopadehe sakshitvam tasseva maya tatkaryantrutvena antaryamita iti bhedah. Chidabhasa vishishta avidyopadehe sakshitvam. So because of the avidya upadhi endowed with reflection of the consciousness, this one can be called sakshi. Tasya maya tatkara niyantritvena. Inasmuch as that sakshi is the niyanta of the maya and the products of the maya, therefore is called antaryami. These are all the names given to the same Paramatma with reference to upadhi. See, for example, we call Param Brahma as the creator. We call him the sustainer. We call him the destroyer. We call him the niyanta. We call him even atma. Why? You take any word which is used with reference to Brahma, again including the word Brahma, what is the need for using any word? Because we come across the creation, therefore we call God as the creator. Because we find that the creation is very systematically and intelligently sustained, therefore we call him sustainer. Because we find that the creation seems to be ultimately, they say, these galaxies are all expanding, and then they will contact the same rate and again go back to their original state. So we find that this laya also is a prakriya, therefore we call him the samharaka. We call him even atma because we find that everything has an essence and therefore he is the essence. He is a self. We call him all pervasive because there is something to pervade. We call him transcendental because there is something to transcend. So we give him all these designations or all the concepts are there about atma. Only because of upadhi. If upadhi were not there, if our experience were not there, he would not have any designation at all because there is nobody to designate. There is nobody to designate and there is nothing to designate with reference to. Every designation must have some reference. Upadhi becomes a reference for us to give designation as sakshi, antaryami and atma and whatever we call. All of these designations are with reference to upadhi. One who himself is devoid of ignorance, even that, said devoid of ignorance, is because we find that we are endowed with ignorance. And then we say, he is devoid of ignorance. And then any kind of an expression that you use will be an expression with reference to upadhi, with reference to some experience, with reference to something that needs to be explained. The life needs to be explained, and therefore, all explanations ultimately will land where? Into him. Sa kastha, sa paragatihi. When you stretch anything, it will ultimately, where will it land? It will only land there. And until it lands there, our explanation is not right. Every problem must land in ignorance. If the problem is not resolved up to ignorance, means we have not understood the problem, or we have not resolved enough. And every truth must always land into Paramatma. Until then we are not resolved. See, when you are resolving, Swamiji, resolve to Karvano. When you resolve, this is always every time, you know. Because the problem, you know, what can you do about the problems? And so you can only resolve them. Otherwise you can't handle them. And therefore, the only way you can resolve the problem is to understand that the problem ultimately arises from ignorance, you know. And you find that where ignorance is, where problem is, the solution is right there, and that solution is Paramatma. That's the only solution. So, in the Vyavahara also you can say that where the problem is, the solution is always there, there is always silver lying in all the clouds, which is also true Vyavaharically, because in Vyavahara also this Lord is present. But ultimately, every problem is to be traced to ignorance, and every solution is to be traced to God or to Self. And so, any designation that we give to Paramatma is always going to be with reference to, even when you call him Sat, Chit, Ananda, Nitya, Shuddha, Buddha, Mukta, anything we call him. Why do we have to call him Satya? Because we find something asatya. Why do we call him Chit? Because we find Jada. Why do we call him Ananda? Because we find Dukkha. Why do we call him Nitya? Because we find Anitya. Why do we call him Mukta? Because we find Baddha. Each of these words only really just negates all of our problems. Every word is nothing but negation of the problem. Because anityatvam is a problem, dukkha is a problem, jadata is a problem, you know, vikara is a problem. All these problems being there, that which is devoid of all the problems. And that has to be there. That has to be there because that is what the human heart seeks. Whenever it comes across problems, naturally it seeks as freedom from that problem. And it has to be there, otherwise that seeking would not be. So we say Nitya, Shuddha, Buddha, Mukta. And we feel such a relief even by using those words. even merely by using those words, Nitya Shuddha Buddha Mukta, itself, you know, makes you so happy that such a thing is there, and it is a self, is not away from me, and therefore in the life there is always a hope, otherwise life would become hopeless. If you think that you can solve any problem vyavahara and feel happy, that is going to be only temporary. You solve a given problem this way, you know, when this pain is kept this way is a problem, you keep it this, alright, then it will interfere with something else, then you keep it some other way. You solve one problem and naturally land into something else, and that's how the world is. And this is what also we should know. And so you go from one place to the other, thinking that you are free, well, there is something else there. You go from there to there, something else is there. So what is the thing which is devoid of free from problem? Nothing. So Swami always like to say, that is why life is always full of challenges. That is why it is called drama. That drama...